Hello, Gemini. We are here for your April season, our Aries season forecast. This is a general forecast, and I'm going to do it by astrological season, which upcoming is Aries in 2 days. So the very first card, the Oracle card that talks about your current energy is patience, having patience. We see a portal there. We see somebody who's ready to take a big step into their future, and it does take patience. So the mischief and magical energy coming in is a magician. Gemini, that is you. You are manifesting. This is the Fairy Oracle by Brian Froud. Okay, let's see what the outcome is for this month is forgiveness. Oh, look at that person feels they're releasing. Forgiveness really allows us to clear our energy. And when you're manifesting, you need all the energy you can have to make that magic. Okay, so the advice from Spirit is Hummingbird Spirit, be here now, live in the moment. All right, so I'm gonna put 3 cards out. And then we're going to clarify everything and see what the messages are. Let's see what is manifesting in the lives of our Gemini friends. I am a Gemini, so I love you. Gemini. You have Mars, the planet of action, on your north node right now. So you are creating a new life for yourself. And you're feeling quite challenged because these are skills that you're building now that you may have. You may have a little bit of those skills, but you're not yet the magician or the master of them. So let's see what we have. 7 of Pentacles. So you're investing. You're investing. You're planting seeds. Ooh, the Hierophant card. Many of you are pursuing some sort of spiritually based growth in your life. You are building a foundation for your life monetarily. Your career looks as though it's growing, and it looks like you're going to achieve a great amount of success. It's in the works as we speak. All right, that's manifesting Taurus energy with those pentacles. Look at this, the Empress card, attracting abundance, the card of Venus, the card of Taurus energy once again. So I don't know what's going on with you, Gemini, but money, abundance, stability, and everything that you love most in life is what you're manifesting right now. So that it's really interesting when you look at this card of patience, because you can see she has a red balloon, and then you can see this big portal with the moon on the other side. So you may find that when we have the full moon in Libra later this month is when you're going to walk through that portal. Exciting. Libra energy could mean a contract, a new job, a business partnership, a different way of going out in the world and presenting what your talents are, and they will be highly valued, especially like if you're in the relationship arena or legal arena. So because Libra rules legal, the 9th house of law, as well as marriages and partnerships. So let's see what the magic, what you're manifesting, because you're manifesting magic. Let's see. Oh, love. Oh, look at this. A beautiful Cancerian, watery, emotional, expressive relationship. One in which somebody shows you that they love you. A lot of fun passion coming in. So this is the magic of the month. So you're going to feel very loved up. You're going to feel very passionate and very free. Now, interestingly enough, this may be a fling instead of a long-term relationship. The 8 of Cups can mean one of 2 things. It'll be different for different people. The 8 of Cups may mean that you're coming into a new love after leaving an old. So you also may have a lover return to you or contact you, somebody from the past. You've walked away from this lover, or they've walked away from you. And you might have walked away from each other. You might have just found that the relationship didn't have enough of what it needed. So, but we'll clarify everything and we'll find answers, because inquiring minds want to know. All right, so in the energy that is your outcome, forgiveness. Forgiveness is so beautiful because it really is for us. Forgiveness is when we just let go. You can see this person sort of releasing the energy that's causing pain in their heart. When we forgive, we release, and we really tap into our spirit. Oh, you're going to be releasing some part of history that was painful. You're going to forgive somebody from the past, somebody who was a soulmate, a lover that you thought you would grow old with. It could be an ex-spouse. It could be even a recent lover, but you're going to forgive somebody. I also see that this person may still come into your life because you have to forgive them to let them back in. So I do think that for some of you, this person I thought had that left probably recently, probably in the last 6 months or 8 months, may be returning. So it'll be different for different people. Depends on who you are. Take what resonates, let the rest stay on the table if it doesn't belong to you. These are general readings. Okay, oh my gosh. The outcome, the Lover's card. So now we have the Lover's card. We have a Lover's card of the Minor Arcana. You know, we get a soulmate card here. Somebody from the past with whom you'd like to grow old, coming back in. Like we have a, you have a soulmate that shows up. Again, could be new, could be a different, you know, soulmate from the past. Most likely for most people, it will be from the past. All right. Seven of Cups, you're keeping your options open. Oh, look at Gemini. This person, you felt as though this person caused you some mayhem when they had player energy, although you didn't have a commitment with them, and you did fall very much in love with them. And it looks like they walked away, or you walked away from the lack of reciprocity, I would say, for most of you. Seven of Cups says that you are keeping your options open. That card is all about you. You recognize that whatever choice you make, you need to be careful because not all of those choices are good. We see a little coral snake down here. So you're very aware though, but you are also aware that forgiveness is going to help you let go of all these worries. Because I really feel instinctively that this card is also a worry card. Like, what if this person walks away? What if this person played me? What if this person is still keeping their options open and yet they're coming back as soulmate energy? So you are very, very much aware of what you're doing this month. And with this forgiveness card, it really speaks about forgiving yourself also. That if you make a mistake, you know, you have to be kind to yourself. If you are not willing to forgive yourself, how can you forgive anybody else? Or how can anyone else forgive you? It's, forgiveness is such a gift. So, of course, back to Hummingbird Spirit. Be in the here and now, live in the moment. You know, let's see what we're gonna see about that. Okay, Four of Coins, live in the moment, let go. What we're seeing here is that you're holding back. Spirit sees you holding back. So this is the advice of Spirit. It says, be cautious. Don't give yourself away. You don't need to tell anybody anything, but you can also, you know, live in the moment and enjoy the moment. You don't have to be really uptight about it because we're seeing this beautiful energy of forgiveness. So let go and forgive. Don't hold old wounds because she looks really unhappy. Don't hold old wounds next to your heart. It's bad for your heart, right? The Ace of Swords. Spirit is saying you know exactly what the score is. You know the truth. You have clarity. And just trust yourself enough to do the right thing. So if this person returns to you and you want to be with them, go ahead, live in the moment. Don't make any finite decisions. Wait for the person to show their truth, whether it's a new truth or an old truth. Trust yourself. You really have all the tools it takes, but that's also a reconciliation card. And Spirit is saying, you know, you have all the tools it takes. We have the Capricorn Queen. Focus on your career, focus on your money, you know, have fun, you know, in the time that you're not working. But this really speaks to the fact that Spirit is saying that, you know, you've got all of this abundance over here. You have this whole portal. And so Spirit is saying, don't get lost in your emotions. Definitely focus, enjoy yourself here, live in the moment with a lover, with some fun, have some magic, but definitely focus on your money because you are about to step into this beautiful trifecta of abundance, and this magician card is bringing it all to fruition. So, you know, let's not forget, you know, you may meet someone with whom you marry, you may have a partner coming in. We have Venus energy, we have that, you know, in your 11th house. You may become, you know, enamored with a friend, you may fall in love with a friend, somebody or that you may have a work association with, but we're really seeing you manifest abundance for yourself independently of anyone else, but you may also partner with a soulmate with whom you share these values. So let's go ahead and clarify. Now I'm going to switch over to the desk view. There we go. All right, so it's kind of fun. I know everybody likes both views, so I'm trying to keep everyone happy. It makes me happy to keep all of you happy. So let's take a look and see what the clarifiers are. Let's see what we have. I'm going to move these cards here. Let's see. Move that and move that. So I have room to shuffle. Okay. We know how if I'm not careful, I shuffle and they spill because I love to shuffle. So why do we have the Seven of Pentacles here? So I see this incredible energy. The seed you are planting is going to create a legacy of abundance. So Hierophant is legacy. Is a legacy card, and the Empress is abundance. You're also attracting love into your life. So because we look at the second house of Taurus, that's three Taurus cards. Spirit, what do these three Taurus cards mean? Strength. You have everything it takes to get from that Seven of Pentacles to the infinity symbol. You may be building wealth that may be multi-generational. For some of you, you may be building a wonderful retirement fund or a wonderful stability in your life that you've never known before, Gemini. All right, you're doing it on your own, neat. The King of Wands energy, you are having fun. The more fun you have while you are manifesting, the more you will manifest. And the Leo King is all about fun, right? The ruler of the fifth house. It's all about a creative expression. So it looks as though most of you are going to experience creating a legacy of abundance for yourself through a creative effort. So if you're an artist, it could be, you know, it could be painting, it could be any, it's children of the mind and body. So it can also mean that you may get pregnant at this time, but you may be pregnant with creative ideas that you are actually manifesting, because with this Empress here, we can see she's also pregnant with the whole world available to her. It looks as though you are stepping through a portal in which you have never experienced before, Gemini. And Geminis are pretty successful overall, but you are, look at this, you are Hierophant again. Oh my gosh, okay. So these energies, when we look at the Hierophant, so the Hierophant is again, the Hierophant here. We have somebody who has been a lover to you may return as a King of Wands. We have Sagittarius energy maturing into Leo energy, and Leo is fixed energy. So we get fixed energy here with Taurus. We're getting a lot of stability. So love and money oftentimes come in together because it's ruled by Venus and the moon. And we also get that, you know, Venus rules the seventh house of marriage. So I'm getting that you are probably manifesting more than you know. You may be opening a beautiful box of magical love, passion, and the ability to leave the past behind by forgiving. So let's see what we have now for the magic and the mischief, or the, you know, the magic and the difficulty, challenges, magic and mayhem. Okay, so let's see. We have this beautiful magician card here. Why is a magician card here in this area of what is happening? Why is a magician card here in this beautiful area? Ace of Swords, you have great clarity. Gemini, you know just what to do. We have Ace of Swords here. So Spirit is saying, go for it, go for it. Ride that pony. Definitely move forward. You know exactly what you need to do. You are going to absolutely be in love with whatever is happening, whatever all of this energy is over here. Absolutely jump into the creativity of it. You have clarity, you have the view of what you need to do. You know what to cut away and go for it. Four of Swords. So it looks as though you've had a go at this a few times now. What I'm seeing is that with the Sagittarius energy, you have sort of taken a run at this. Whatever this project is that you're doing, it looks as though you've tried it and you haven't, you've had some spills. But you know, the old saying in business is you learn a lot more from your quote unquote failures, which is, you know, we see this Knight of Wands. So there's fleeting success. So you've had some fleeting success. You haven't been able to stabilize it. That's the mayhem. And you have to leave something behind and heal so that you can have the courage to go back into this. So the Magician card says you have courage. The Magician card says you have clarity. And the Magician card says that which you walked away from, sort of like, you know, you're walking back in. You're walking into your sun. And we have the Leo energy here in the Strength card. So that is Leo energy once again. So you're really walking into your happiness. Now, your outcome card, let's see. Well, why do we have the Queen of Cups here? Why is the Queen of Cups here? Two of Coins. Okay, so you have two loves, two possibilities. You may be juggling two different skill sets. I think for many of you, this is really two different aspects of a business. And it looks as though you love both. One of them has money attached to it. One of them you do simply because you love it so much. But it's really powerful. We see the Four of Coins repeating here, the Four of Coins. So it does look like you're being very careful with your money. You know where to spend it. You're making very judicious investments. Sometimes you don't know exactly what to do, and I think that comes with the past, letting go of this energy here where you feel as though your first go round, your first effort at this didn't work out. The Page of Swords says you're studying things online, you're learning the answers, you're about ready to go. That Two of Coins says you're going to try different things, two different ideas. You're going to be careful about the money that you use. Why is the Eight of Cups here for you? What are you leaving behind? Because that is still Gemini energy. Let's see, what was left behind that was magical? All right. Ooh, throwing caution to the winds was magical. Talking and sharing with friends was magical because you have a lot of support in this endeavor. The Three of Wands says that your ships have come in and you are leaving behind hermit energy. You were searching for answers, you now have them, okay? That's part one. Okay, so that's what you left behind. The mayhem that you left behind was uncertainty, taking a stab at something and not really landing the, oh, it's like in gymnastics, you know, yes, she landed a 10. So you didn't land a 10, but you learned invaluable information about what you're manifesting over here. And you have left behind uncertainty. You've left behind everything that hasn't served you, and you're right there again at it, okay? So let's clarify the energy of forgiveness. Why do we have forgiveness? Sometimes we have to forgive ourselves because we'll beat ourselves up if we failed. You have to forgive somebody though for lying to you. Somebody came in, you had a lover who was keeping their options open, okay? That is, so the outcome is you're going to have a lover and you have great clarity. You understand that somebody didn't treat you well, they didn't treat you right. You're going to forgive them. Tell us about the Seven of Swords. What was that about? What was the lie that Gemini was told that Gemini will forgive? I feel like it was keeping options open, but let's see. Oh my God. Okay. This is so different than I thought it was. Okay. So I really felt that you were dealing with somebody that you need to forgive because they lied to you, and you're feeling, you thought they had their options open. For some of you, that may be the case. But what I'm seeing is what you didn't see, because Eight of Swords, self-imposed restriction, what you didn't see with the Seven and Eight of Swords was that this person thought that you were a rock star. and that they didn't tell you. The way they were keeping their options open was they just didn't confirm with you that they loved you. They didn't make that commitment to you. They loved you. You are the rock star. That is hopes and dreams for love coming true. And so it looks as though, we're going to go back and clarify this to see if this person is the one who's coming back in. This person here is this card. Also, your endeavor here is you leaving some uncertainty. So we see the card. Sometimes cards have multiple meanings and layers to a reading. I feel like readings are like onions. Some parts are sweet and some parts make you cry. But look at this victory. You felt as though this person left you behind because they were a player, and yet this is also a dual reading. It's part business for you. And when they walked away from you, they walked away feeling very victorious, a little bit arrogant. This is Leo energy. So this Leo King over here, you might have thought, you know, they didn't really make that commitment. They didn't step up into that. They did think that you were a rock star, but they didn't step up to that level of commitment. It's possible that they return to give you that level, but let's see. What is the Six of Wands now? Wanting to return for love. Love, love. So that's the magic. The magic of this is your person wants to return for love. This person wants to return because you're so nurturing, because you're so kind. Okay, so now that we know that what they didn't tell you was that they loved you, let's see. They just didn't make a decision. Nine of Cups. So the Nine of Cups is also Seven of Cups, Nine of Cups. They're missing you. When we look, you were their happiness. This is the happiest. This is eat, drink, and be merry. Let's have fun. You can see all this flowing wine here and water. Seven of Cups can be drinking. The Nine of Cups is drinking with somebody you love, drinking with your best friends. It's usually like a wedding, a community celebration. This person's lonely without you. We get the Star card. So let's look and see what they're going to tell you. What is this person going to tell you when they come back? The Six of Cups says that they're going to return. That is your lover returning from the past. Ace of Coins, a significant offer. Okay, so when we get the Ace of Coins, that can be a ring. We don't have the Three of Cups for an engagement, but they're coming back in with a significant offer, something that's grounded. Again, coins are tangible, tangible offers. That's like, let's move in together. Let's make plans together. Let's talk about marriage. Let's talk about all of this energy here. So part of your success may be that you're attracting a partner again who matches you, as well as manifesting on your own. You're manifesting within the parameters of a larger story. So beautiful. Oh, wow. Okay, reconciliation. There we go. Number one card. And look at this. When we get Temperance with the Star card, this is, you know, you being able to let go of the past, let go of your worries, you know, just really take this person at their word. They're going to prove themselves to you. There are no cards of deception here at all. They want to come back. They want to win with you, Gemini. All right, so let's see what we have in terms of spirit's advice, and that is hummingbird energy with, you know, live in the here, live in the moment, be here and now. You know, spirit is suggesting that you don't give everything up immediately. Four of Coins says that you should be forgiving, but, you know, you can still be self-protective. It's not time to make a decision right now. In the first month that this person comes back, keep, you know, you're not going to make a decision. It's not time to make a choice yet. Even though you're at a crossroads, they will want you to commit to taking them back fully. Because I see the three, but you're gonna say no. You put me in a, you hurt me badly. The things that you did, the things that you said, you know, you didn't give me what I needed. And so we see the Knight of Swords coming back in to try to gain clarity, but you're still hurting. So Spirit is saying it's okay, you can protect yourself. You know, you can face whatever the truth is. You can speak bluntly to this person and they can speak to you. This is a person you may marry. This is going to be a very hot topic because I have love success here for you, as well as financial career success is off the charts. So the Queen of Pentacles here is your spirit telling you, oh wow, okay, great. Spirit is saying, the advice of spirit is, if someone isn't willing to settle down and go from the Nine of Cups to the Ten of Cups, that would end in making you feel betrayed, and that you don't need that, and that the Libra Queen should cut anything out of her life that doesn't serve her, including spending your resources, your energy, giving love to someone who doesn't reciprocate. So it's very much about equal give and take, and it's living in the moment and trusting yourself. Yep, there we go, Five of Cups, okay. So what we're seeing here is spirit is saying that you have to allow the other person, okay, this is beautiful. Spirit is saying that, this is Cancerian energy, that you just live your own truth and let this person deal with whatever they do. You're going to forgive them for spilling your love. You're going to forgive them because you're a higher spiritual, person. And it shows that this person was foolish, and though you will forgive them, you still have wisdom. So you will live in the moment, you will trust yourself, and if they start to resort to this behavior, then the message is very clear. If they start to bounce back into this sort of keep holding back from you, not really giving to you, you know, you'll cut them out of your life. So that is your reading, Gemini. Thank you. So Gemini, my gosh, what an incredible reading. Your career, your creativity is off the charts. Mars in Gemini is going to propel you into the next, how often? I think 14 years before you have Mars with the North Node again in Gemini. So I would just really say, dive in, live in the moment, have courage, go home, go large or go home. No, go big or go home. That's the energy here. Trust spirit in helping guide you intuitively as to whether this soulmate energy is really ready for love. You're going to know exactly what to do. You are so empowered. And I just want to ask, if you enjoy this, please like, subscribe, share, comment. That's how YouTube really knows that you enjoy the content. That's their message. And sending you love from Chicago. Send some back. Leave a comment below, please. Take care. Thank you. Bye-bye.